That concludes EHR certification. The other two components of high tech are meaningful use and incentive payments. Before we discuss them, we'll have a basic overview of electronic medical records. Physicians are in the data business. They collect data, they make treatment decisions based on that data, and they follow patients through other data and make adjustments as needed. The data physicians record can be divided into subjective information, generally information collected from the patient, such as the chief complaint, the reason they visited the physician today, their medical history, and the history of the particular problem that brought them to the doctor. Physicians may collect objective data by doing a physical exam, ordering x-rays or other images, or doing lab tests. The resulting data can be in many forms. It can be free text, it can be structured codes such as the ICD we referred to earlier, could be continuous waveforms from an electrocardiogram, images, sound recordings, or even videos. Increasingly, data from chronic disease and other patients may be coming from their smartphone or from physiologic measurement devices they use to track their own health at home. Storing and presenting this rich data set is an EMR design challenge. Yet many EMRs still mimic the organization of the paper chart, even simulating the tabs that divide the sections where the data types are stored. Despite its key role in medicine, physicians have historically focused far more on collecting the right data than they have on recording it completely, accurately, and legibly. As we've seen, in a fragmented system of care where many physicians treat aspects of a single patient's care, this can lead to duplicate testing or even errors. Here's a particularly dramatic example. For which medication was this prescription written? Was it Isoril, Plendil, or are you not sure?